Let's try to write down an algorithm that systematizes how we solved it. And we're going to write this as pseudocode. That means we're not worrying about the details of how to write exactly correct Python. We're trying to get the idea down and see if it makes sense. So let's think about how we solved the problem as a human again. Here's how we started. We looked at our start date, which was January 24, and we counted the number of days remaining in January. We did that by just counting up. If we started earlier, we might not want to have counted every day. So we can subtract the total number of days in January from the day we started on. So that will be our starting point. And we're going to keep the result in a variable called days. And we'll start by initializing days to the number of days in the current month minus the day that we're starting on. So for the example, that was 31 for the number of days in January minus 24, which I believe is 7. And once we've done that, well, we finished month one, so we should increase the value of month one by one. So now we were at February, and now we started going through the months until we got to the month we were on. So we went through each month until we got up to the month we were looking for, which was June. So that's sort of like a while loop. We're doing something over and over again until we get to the stopping condition. So we can write that as pseudocode. We're going to keep going while the current month is less than the target month. We're going to add the number of days in the current month, and we're going to increase the current month by one. Now we're not quite done. We still need to account for the day in the month that we arrived at, and there we just add that day. So if it was day one of June, we would add one since we didn't actually get into June. Now we're going to add 29 since the 29th was our target day. We haven't yet accounted for years. For this example, that was okay, but for other cases, we're going to need to account for years. So let's think about how to do that. We can do it similarly to how we accounted for month. While we're not up to the same year, we're going to add the number of days in that year.